turmoil and raising the prospect of a government shutdown, U.S. President Donald Trump has vetoed a bipartisan defense policy bill. Trump vetoed the defense policy bill, which has passed every year since 1961. The defense bill authorizes a top line of $740 billion in spending and also outlines Pentagon's policy. Trump said he objected to liability protections for social media companies unrelated to national security. Trump also said he did not want to rename military bases that are currently named for generals who fought for the pro-slavery Confederacy during the Civil War. Democrats and Republicans objected to Trump's veto of the National Defense Authorization Act. The House would now return on December 28th to vote on whether to override Trump's veto or not. The National Defense Authorization Act passed both houses of Congress earlier this month by veto-proof margins, which means that any veto by Trump would likely be overridden. Trump has demanded dramatic changes to a $2.3 trillion package that funds the federal government and provides nearly $900 billion in coronavirus aid. Donald Trump is demanding lawmakers to raise the coronavirus aid part of the spending bill so as to include $2,000 payments to each American, which is more than triple the $600 per person provided. Donald Trump assailed the package in a video he tweeted suggesting he may not sign it.
The bill they are now planning to send back to my desk is much different than anticipated. It really is a disgrace. I am asking Congress to amend this bill and increase the ridiculously low $600 to $2,000 or $4,000 for a couple. I'm also asking Congress to immediately get rid of the wasteful and unnecessary items from this legislation.
If Donald Trump blocks the spending package, large parts of the U.S. government could start to shut down next week for lack of funds. It's highly concerning at a time when officials are distributing two coronavirus vaccines and working to respond to a massive hacking attack. Trump is angry that some Republicans have acknowledged his loss to Democrat Joe Biden in the November 3rd election. Trump has less than a month left in office as Biden will be sworn in as president on January 20th. Both the bills passed by Congress by wide bipartisan margins. The Yarn is now available in your country. Download the app now. Get all the news on the move.